everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we are doing summer blossoms. We're just going to take a quick little tour around and concentrate on what is blooming right now. The first one we're going to look at is our water lily. This is the first blossom of the year. It's absolutely gorgeous, and they were difficult to find, but we finally got them. The next two we'll put together, they're Asiatic lilies. So these come up every year, very reliable. Sometimes you have to protect them from the deer. And then these are cut and come zinnias that I grew from seeds. This is a Weigela or Weigela. This is called Polka. Now this is one that has already blossomed, but it decided to do two more just for this.
When you say Polka, is it like the dance?
Like the dance, polka? Right, yes.
Oh, okay. Did you want to dance around the garden?
Sunflowers. Now, hello, and a visitor. These are sunflowers that I planted from the bird seed that we had last year. So in the fall, I just took the old heads off of the sunflowers and I threw a bunch over here, and they came up for this year. Now this is Strawberry Sundae Hydrangea. These, as they mature, will get a pink cast to them. So they start out white, start out yellow, actually white, and then they'll be pink. Very beautiful. This kind of wild plant here is called an Indian plantain. Lots of blossoms. The pollinators love it, and it's very prolific. And the leaf structure is interesting. Not your regular leaf structure.
It kind of reminds me of that popcorn plant that you had when you're...
Yes, a senna, I think it was.
Yeah, this plant is almost 5 foot tall.
And I just chopped this down at the end of the season. And it comes right back. These are Canterbury bells. And they're at the end of their period, but you can see the bees are still loving them. And this is what they look like inside. Very pretty.
Ding dong.
Rose of Sharon. Now this poor thing is hidden away under a tree, and still it goes on and on. Now there is part of this bush, and possibly another part of it, or a different one that's right next to it, has some red in it also. But this one is pure white. This is another way we plant sunflowers, or the birds do. Comes in the feed, drops on the ground, grows into more feed. These, you know, most of them are tall and spindly. The birds love them. This one is huge, yes. And then there's another one a little way over. So what I've been doing then, as they finish up and before the birds eat all of the seeds out of them, I'll chop these off and, like I said before, toss them in the back 40 and they come up again next year.
We have a back 40, 40 inches.
Now this one's going to be a large one. You can tell by the sturdiness of the stalk.
Yeah.
And there is another head over there.
Oh yeah, that is a biggie.
That was as big as a shower head.
They're amazing.
All right, the ones that they're not really blossoms yet. Caladium. These are mostly for the leaves. You plant them, they're tender bulbs, but they are going to blossom. So I don't know if you can see this one over here.
Yep.
But it goes to a blossom. Liatris, or blazing star, people call it. Now when they start out, they're just a singular little thing, and they may get this tall, But the longer they stay in one place, the more they multiply, and thus you have a variety. This one I was holding together with some, just some wrapping ribbon, only because they do tend to flop over sometimes as they get bigger.
How about in here?
These are all dahlias. These, these were new ones that we bought this year. And a variety of colors. Again, I'll deadhead them so that they continue to produce. If you don't deadhead them, they think they are done. Rose mallow. This is the hibiscus. This is the hibiscus family. This is how all those beautiful giant hibiscus came to be.
Now, did you plant this one here?
I don't remember. No, they kind of plant themselves where they want. Snapdragons. Possibly your grandparents grew these. I planted these 1 year, and there was a variety pack, obviously, and I just leave them there when the season's over. This Mexican sunflower, planted from seed. Bees love them. They get quite large if you plant them soon enough. And very colorful.
And again, more sunflowers.
More sunflowers.
That we didn't grow.
No. Well, we're growing them, but we didn't plant them. All right. More dahlias. This was a variety of colors together. This is butterfly weed. This comes up. This is a perennial. It'll be here. Monarch butterflies love it.
That's one of my favorite of the butterfly plants.
Dahlias again. So beautiful. They're so majestic.
I like the, I know you don't particularly care for bugbane, right?
This is bugbane, right. And while I can accept the fact that it's beautiful and it's different, those fuzzy ones will be coming out of here soon because I don't want them everywhere. They will invade and be everywhere. But look down here. Remember when we removed all the daisies?
Oh, you deadheaded everything.
I did. I took them all down to the bottom.
Second blossom.
Yep. There they go. Cannas. This is a bulb, a tender bulb again. You dig it up in the fall, take it in, put it in the house, bring it back out, and this, I mean, just the leaves alone are gorgeous. And they come in red like this, or maroon, and they also come in plain green. Different flower colors as well are available.
This one is almost 6 foot tall already.
Well, I'm 5'9".
I'm not quite 5'9 yet. I mean, talk more about
dahlias.
A bouquet.
Yes.
I mean, just walking out here.
Well, and you see the different stages. I mean, they're all different stages that you can appreciate when they're tiny like this and you think, oh, that looks like a daisy. And then they advance and then they get to be like this. And then they get to be like this. Truly amazing flowers. They're worth the trouble that they cause when you're trying to keep them over winter. Balloon flowers. This is the season of balloon flowers. They seem to be very, very happy this year. We started with only blue. Somehow we got white.
Purple, pink.
Mm-hmm, or pink with tinges.
I love how they start out like a little...
Well, they're a balloon.
A balloon.
Right.
And
so here's a balloon. Right. And our boys used to always try to pop them because it's fun. Why not? And it doesn't bother them. And they always... Five beautiful leaves.
Well, remember that 1 year we found one that had seven?
There was one with seven. Yes. And I've never seen that one again.
Well.
So it was a mutation. Although, what is this? This is six, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep, this is six. But the inside is just so gorgeous.
Pollinators like them.
They do. This is for you, Scott Miller, Joe Pye Weed. Now, this is a little shorter this year than it has been, probably because of all the mulch that it's fighting with. These are a form of honeysuckle. And again, pollinators love them. Hummingbirds love them. Butterflies love them.
I thought we had lost this amongst the giant...
The trumpet vine?
No, the one we just cut down.
Oh.
The giant fleece plant. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yes. And if you listen closely, you hear a storm brewing in the background. So we're kind of in a rush. This is one of my favorite coneflowers because it's so very bright.
I like how it has that little white edges when it first starts out.
Yes.
It's like on the backside.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Very pretty.
More liatris.
There we go. There we go. I'm gonna melt. Dahlia.
I love these dahlias. I mean, they are just putting on a show.
Yeah, they're happy. This is their weather.
Marigolds.
Marigolds. I don't remember what those little red ones are, but they're very pretty. Sweet alyssum. Snapdragons that planted themselves, and that is a kind of yarrow that I planted from seed last year. This is probably our most exotic of the dahlias. They are just amazing. Zinnias, obviously. This was a Mexican sunflower that I guess I decided to put there. More zinnias. And then I believe this is coxcomb.
Yep.
And then also Scott Miller gave me a different kind of coxcomb, so that's here. Planted by seeds and nasturtiums. Nasturtiums are edible.
Salad tonight?
And then more sunflowers.
And what did you plant in here that haven't blossomed
yet? In here, these are tiny dahlias that you bought at the store.
Oh,
you
flat of them.
Flat of tiny little dahlias. Now, they only get to be maybe this tall. I have some that are blooming in the back. And the flowers are smaller, but they're beautiful. Real phlox. This is the actual phlox that is planted. It has a beautiful fragrance to it, and you can see it's got five petals. P-H-L-O-X, phlox. Comes back every year. Likes to spread around, so be careful. This is a dwarf limelight hydrangea tree. Now, this is the first year we've had this one. We planted this in the spring, and we were surprised that it would be blossoming this year. More cannas. Have not yet bloomed, but they will. And then there's another honeysuckle.
Yeah. It's amazing the variety of honeysuckles there are.
Yes. Speedwell. This thing is years and years old, and it continues to struggle, but there it is. We unleashed it with all the bindweed, and now it's doing nicely. Purple phlox. Again, very fragrant. Does like to spread. Bees love it. And it goes so nicely with this color of dahlia. Giant Hardy Hibiscus, dinner plate size hibiscus flowers. How can you even describe that? It's a wedding bouquet in one.
And what's neat is every day a brand new one will form.
Right.
And it'll just keep blossoming and blossoming and blossoming.
This will be tomorrow.
Yeah.
And this one will be done.
And
but
it's
just
loaded.
Go on and on.
Now these are the ones we just moved this spring.
Right.
And
these were behind the
free library,
and Logan and Luke moved this one.
Yeah, a lot of blossoms too.
Mm-hmm. These, we call them tickweed. I think they're in the red black-eyed Susan family. Rebecca, perhaps. Again, more rose mallow, and again, this is where the hibiscus comes from. The mallow family. Somehow this spring, we decided this was not a peony. This is a TomatoBerry.
You think so?
It certainly looks like
wow.
it.
That's came a up, hybrid.
Yeah, came up. We don't know how it got here. We'll see. Cup plant. Gets over 6 feet tall. Forms little cups wherever there is a leaf. And it collects water, so it kind of waters itself over time. The flowers aren't that amazing, but they certainly do get tall. And
my
the
goodness.
Pollinators like them.
I would say that's close to 9 foot tall.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing.
This is a wild snapdragon. Some people call it egg and butter or bacon and eggs or whatever. It will take over. I just pull them out. Whatever.
Remember all the yucca?
All the yucca flowers, that you had? Right?
They were amazing.
Need to get those out of here. I do not want more yucca right there.
And more sunflowers that we didn't plant.
Right.
And these are coreopsis, you said?
That's coreopsis, right. The daisy form.
It gives a nice kind of balanced entrance to the book library.
Right. We were trying to be symmetrical. So we got liatris, coreopsis, sunflowers. Again, sunflowers, and yes, I did throw heads over here as well. So they pretty much planted themselves, but I threw in the head to start them. This is where my hedge of liatris lives. You can see how it just goes on and on and on. I share these if people stop over. You can also see there is morning glories growing there, but we won't talk about them.
Better not talk about them.
And then over here, the wisteria
over
is,
there, there's a really nice one still.
Yes, the wisteria is blooming again.
Yeah, this
amazing,
is the second.
Amazing.
This was
plant.
Just full. And you can see by the seeds.
Yeah, the seeds are very healthy. We've chopped many off.
I probably eliminated half of this.
Oh, at least, yes.
I mean, because you couldn't even walk through it at one point.
No, I mean, not unless you were about 10 years old.
Oh, and then before we go.
Oh, yes, this is compass plant. We've talked about it many a time.
But that too, right now, is probably 7 foot tall.
Yes, just beautiful. Native, doesn't require any help whatsoever, except maybe to stalk it up so it doesn't bend over. More phlox, of course. These are prairie sunflowers that we thought we got out of here.
Yeah.
More phlox. This is Laura. You can see it's a little bit different from the other phlox we have. And this is called golden yarrow. Very reliable plant. We do have it caged so it stays upright, but I mean, this goes on and on. And if you cut off the old blossoms once they get a little browner, it will start again, flower for you.
And your hostas are at the end of their blossoms.
Hostas are here, yep.
Now we're waiting for our jasberry jam.
Jasberry jam hibiscus. Right, lots and lots of blossoms.
Yep.
The giant, this is the original giant dinner plate size hibiscus.
Yeah. Every other plant you see on the property came from this one.
Every other white one.
The white one, right. And again, you can see the number of blossoms just for today.
Right. Well, this was yesterday.
Yep.
So this one's done. So they are kind of messy that way. But they're worth it. I mean, they're just absolutely gorgeous. This is a Midnight Marvel. Again, different variety. Doesn't get quite as tall.
But massive blossoms.
Yep.
Oh, gee, more liatris.
And there's some white. Oh, that's white. Smartweed. Well, the flower isn't that
impressive.
Look at how it attracts the Japanese beetles and keeps it off of other plants.
So it's a sacrificial plant.
It is. Thank you.
And then you have the Lunas,
right. The Luna variety of hibiscus are shorter. So this is a pink squirrel. And then that's our mystery one that we, for whatever reason, we don't have a sign for that one. Very, very pretty. And next to it is another pink and red one. That one we have a sign for, but we don't know. I can't read it from
somehow
here.
It disappeared.
Well, the sign for that one is right there.
Oh, way back there.
Right. Yeah.
And then you've got another Luna.
This is another Luna.
But I think
Luna.
This one's going to be red because I can see
right
the red blossom starting back there.
Yes. And right to your right there is another yarrow. That is a pink yarrow. Coneflower, white one. Very pretty. So firm and prickly.
Aren't these spectacular?
Yes. These again, Asiatic lilies. Love the freckles. This is a double coneflower. So you can see how they start out like this. More coreopsis.
And then in the container.
That is a Mexican sunflower. Again, this is one I grew from seed. And I keep chopping off the old ones so that it'll keep going longer and longer. I have to almost come out every day to chop these off.
Well, they're taller than you, so they're taller than me. So they've got to be about 6.5 feet
well,
now.
So are these tomatoes taller than you?
Yeah. Oh,
oh dear.
Oh, look what's happening.
Yep.
Oh, boy.
Uh-huh.
Well, I have to tell you, I snuck my first one.
Uh-huh. I bet you did.
And it was delicious. There's nothing like a homegrown tomato.
Nope.
Oh, my goodness. You know, you can buy it off the vine at the store.
Not the same. It's grown in a greenhouse.
Yeah.
This is grown in sunshine.
And these, talk about indeterminate.
Yeah.
These are already 7 foot tall. And look at all the blossoms. They'll just keep going and going and going until the very end.
Here, maybe you need one.
No, that one's
this
not.
This one's not quite ready.
No, like I said, I snuck them out yesterday.
Yeah, this one's better.
I mean, look, just look at that shape. It's like a perfect little strawberry, a little hard. I remember the story, the little Japanese girl, the father who was a botanist, he was trying to develop a new form of tomato.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why they don't get in the house. Anyhow, he grew this plant and harvested a tomato, looked at it, studied it, and he was so disappointed he threw it in the garbage. And his little, I think she was a
five-year-old
daughter, came by, looked in the garbage can, and pulled it out and said, "Papa, you created a heart."
Mm-hmm.
And so he re-looked at it once more, and he thought, well, maybe I have something here. And lo and behold, if you can hold that sign for me.
My husband should get the commission on this.
I think we should get royalties for this, because we have talked about this for probably the last 7 or 8 years since we first found them. They don't split. They don't fall off the vines.
Right. They stay on the vines. They don't split until the very end of the year, or if they're really drought-ridden. But they're marvelous.
And talk about sweetness. And
yeah.
The longer you keep them, this. Oh, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for sharing.
We hope you enjoyed this short little scurrying around yard tour. It's raining on and off, so if you did and you really like them, please give us a thumbs up. We have to get in before I melt, so if you'd like to visit other videos, please come to our wisconsingarden.com website. Also, if you'd like to become part of our garden family and you haven't subscribed yet, there is a little button over here, kind of a reddish orange button. And also
it's an arrow.
Above it, there's a little bell that will tell you when a new one comes out. Stay safe, stay dry, stay wet, whatever you need in your part of the country. And thank you so much for watching and supporting us. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube.